Originally, this video was going to be called Everything I Watched in January of 2022. I'm halfway through writing the script, it's 4 pages long, you don't want to watch a 40-minute long video, and more importantly, I want to post before the turn of the decade. Looking at my track record, not so good. Luckily, for all of 2021, I wrote down every movie I watched and rated them out of 10. I left the whole list of everything down in the description if you're interested, there you go. Top 3 movies of 2021 that I watched. Listen, there's nothing I love more and find more enjoyment out of than pissing off the Spider-Man community. That's why I'm not gonna be talking about this shitty dumpster fire of a movie. Today we're talking about this broken, middle child S-tier film that always brings a smile to my cold, empty, lifeless face. I love Spider-Man, and I think the best way to start taking a look at this film and the impact it's had on me personally is to look at the end.
There were only 10 different plots in all of fiction. Well, I'm here to tell you who was wrong. There is only one. Who am I?
That's the entire point of this movie. Peter tries to find himself, to find his voice. At the start, he's quiet and stuttering over every line, and at the end, he is calm and steady. Of course, there's so much broken about this movie. Call it nostalgia, call it bias, but it's incredibly easy for me to give it a pass. Studio interference and Avi Arad aside, I think Mark Webb had an amazing vision and an amazing story to tell that tragically will never be told purely. One major theme through the abyss of Spider-Man stories is responsibility. Except for you. The iconic phrase, with great power comes great responsibility, has been oversaturated to the point of losing most of its true meaning. It wasn't until it was explained by Martin Sheen that I fully understood what it meant.
But your father lived by a philosophy, a principle, really. He believed that if you could do good things for other people, you had a moral obligation to do those things. That's what's at stake here. Not choice, responsibility.
This is my favorite deconstruction of the iconic quote. Uncle Ben breaks it down to its simplest meaning. Be kind to others with no excuses. I think the skateboarding was cool, and I like Coldplay. I'm only human.
The makings of greatness in you. But you gotta take the helm and charge your own course. Stick to it, no matter the squalls. And when the time comes, you get the chance to really test the cut of your sails and show what you're made of. Well, I hope I'm there, catching some of the light coming off you that day.
All right, I'm gonna get this out of the way first. In my notes, I spelt treasure like this. This film is my favorite version of the story that Disney has told so far. What the fuck? Treasure Island came out in the 50s, and no one was alive then. Then the Muppet one came out in the 90s, but Gonzo is kind of a jackass. Fuck you! Leaving us with Treasure Planet. Look at this film. This film is gorgeous. It's so clear that this was a passion project from the beginning. Treasure Planet was groundbreaking in its animation style. This basically means that John Musker and Ron Clements watched the vine scene from Tarzan and did it better. This is the first time that mixed animation styles were used for a whole movie. Sure, some parts look dated, but who cares, right? We have shots that look like this, and it makes the muddy shots look so much better and way easier to look past.
What?
All right, 60% of you have probably never seen this movie before. 40% of you are probably thinking, really? You had 3 spots to pick 3 movies and you chose Project Almanac. Quick fun fact about me. I'm a dirty little slut when it comes for shitty sci-fi movies where the science doesn't make sense. You know what? No. What do all of these movies have in common? They're laced with crack, okay? That's what it is. Project Almanac is no exception. It's a found footage where the protagonist finds a video from his 7th birthday and sees himself in the present. The protagonist then snoops on his dead dad's science work and accidentally creates time travel. Very simple. Does this movie have any sort of emotional depth? No. Does this movie have anything to make it stand out from the hundreds of other sci-fi movies? No. Did I love this movie enough to buy it on DVD? Yes. And I think that says enough. Thanks for watching. It's going to be redundant if I keep apologizing for not posting in every video I post, so I'm not going to. However, I will tell you that you should go follow me on Letterboxd, because I am going to log every single movie for 2022. And if any of you want to comment your favorite movie, I'll watch it. Maybe I'll make a video on it. Just give me movies. I like watching them, so hope you enjoy.